We want to consider dating strategies or dating strategy that works for a blissful family. Dating strategy that works. It means that there are certain things that do not work, certain steps that you may take that may fail you, disappoint you, break you, scatter you, destroy your life. That is the opposite side of this message, dating strategy. The one that works, we want to consider. And we also want to look at the one that does not work, that will not make us to be happy in life. Let's begin with Jeremiah chapter 10. Jeremiah chapter 10, we read from verse 23. Jeremiah chapter 10, reading from verse 23. O Lord, I know that the will of man is not in himself. It is not in man that walketh to direct his step. This prophet is qualified to say, to make this statement because of his experience in life. This prophet, when he was a child, when he was very, very young, God called him and said, before you are formed in your mother's womb, I knew thee. And before you came out of your mother's womb, I sanctified you, separated you for a purpose, for a plan, for a goal that I have in my mind. I separated you to preach the gospel, to go from nation to nation, to build and to make something wonderful for my glory. No wonder why he said, O Lord, I know that the way of man is not in himself. All I had in plan originally, what I had in plan to be this, to be this, to be that, everything canceled because of your supremacy, because of your own will that you have established right from heaven. O Lord, I know that the way of man is not in himself. A man may have this other plan, that other plan, that other plan. This is what I'm going to be in life. This is the type of a person I'm going to marry. This is where I'm going to settle in life. Yes, one may have such wonderful devices. But here, Jeremiah said from his own experience that he had a similar case with your case. I had planned to be this, to be that, but God called me when I was very, very young, when I did not even have much understanding, that before I formed thee, which means he formed me, he formed you in your mother's belly for a purpose in life. He said, before you came out of your mother's womb to begin to run after what you had in mind originally, I separated you for a purpose. That's what Prophet Jeremiah is telling you and telling me. Oh Lord, I know that the way of man is not in himself. It is not in man that walketh, not in his father or mother. This is what I want my daughter to be. This is what I want my son to be. This is the direction I want my children to go. That is your own. But God has the final say, according to one of the crosses you sang here. Because it is not a man that walketh to direct his steps. Proverbs 10, 9. Proverbs 10, let's read verse 9. It says, Proverbs, just a minute. Proverbs chapter 16, verse 9. Proverbs 16, I read verse 9. It says, a man's heart deviseth his way. There are many devices in your heart. I have so many devices also. But I found myself here in Russia. I never knew. I had a different plan altogether. It was like a joke when it all started. And when God began to unfold his plan for my life, according to the history, the story, my parents told me before I was born, how they were warned specifically that they should take care of me for a purpose which I will not reveal to you. The point I'm making is this: God has a plan for every individual on the face of the earth. You can't say, I will go here, I will go here, I will go. Yes, you can say so, but when he arises, as from Jonah, he will tell you the story. He will tell you all he had in mind. He never wanted to go to Nineveh. But when God rose up, he was bent low. He was broken. He was swallowed up by a fish. And he began to beg before he was permitted out on to the way nearer to Nineveh, where God commanded him to be. What are we saying? A man's heart deviseth his way. But the Lord, the Almighty, please do your hand like this and do it to him. It belongs to him. Hallelujah. Amen. The Lord directed his steps. Chapter 20, verse 24. Chapter 20, verse 24. It says, man's goings are of the Lord. How can a man then understand his way? Limited man, short-sighted man of yesterday. How can he understand except the Holy Ghost comes in, except God of heaven speaks to him, except God open his eye to see, except God open his understanding, except there's enlightenment from the Holy Spirit? How can he know who she is, who he is, where he is, when he's going to be, and how it's going to be accomplished? How can a mortal, limited man know his own way except through God the Almighty? Every man born into the world has his own God ordained plan for him to carry out on the face of the earth. There's also a specific man. Everybody says specific. Everybody says specific. A particular man, a particular woman attached to a man or to a woman. And if you should take a round peg or put a round peg in the square hole, there'll be weeping, there'll be crying, there'll be pain, there'll be agony, there'll be sorrow, there'll be heartbreak, there will be cutting short of life if somebody should put his leg in a wrong place. God has his own ordained flesh of his flesh, bone of his bone, attached to every individual on the face of the earth. And that is why we are considering dating strategies that we make you not to have problem in future. And if, as we delve into it, it will help you to escape the incompatible killing pair. It will help you and keep you from demonized men and women. It will preserve you from heartache and hypertension. It will preserve you and keep you from unsuffering, unpleasant, embarrassment and experiences. It will also grant you rest. It will grant you peace and long life. That is, it will take heed That is if you are obedient. That is rich. That is if you are not stubborn about it. That is if you don't feel you know more than God who created you into this world. That is if you submit and surrender to the will of the Father. Therefore, to achieve this goal, it is mandatory, it is expedient, it is necessary that you will ask from the omniscience God, the maker of heaven and earth, to lead us to the right place, even to live. Right place to study. Many people came, or some people came, they died here because they didn't go to the right place they are supposed to go. They perished here. This is what the Lord is telling you, that even the right place to live, the right place to study, the right place to walk, the right man and woman to marry, it is God himself alone who knows. And this is the only way we can avoid sadness and sorrow throughout our lifetime. But let me tell you this, it is useless to desire the will of God on any subject, including marriage, if we are not willing to be obedient. If we have chosen the path to follow, there is no need bothering ourselves, telling you this is how to do it, this is how to do it. But at any rate, we just have to do it. We have to tell you if you will obey. My prayer is that you will obey in Jesus' name. Amen. Ask, even yourself, some of you are from broken homes. You know the heartache of the father, the heartache of the mother. That is enough to even tell you that, oh, what my mother is passing through, what my father is passing through, I pray that I will not pass through it, you will not pass through it. Yeah. Give me a louder amen. Yeah. Give me a louder amen. Yeah. Jeremiah chapter 6 verse 16 says, thus says the Lord, stand ye in the ways. The Lord Almighty is speaking, stand ye in the ways. So many ways. And see and ask for the old path. Old path. Not the modern path. Not demonized path. Not social path. Not scientific path, the old paths. Where is the good way, singular, good way, and walk therein, and ye shall find rest for your souls. But he said, Jeremiah, no matter what you preach, no matter what you say, as for that man, as for that woman, God answers prayer. We will go to God. We will pray. We will change him. We will change her. When you are in willful obedience, when you deliberately put your feet where you shouldn't put your feet, and you say, God is there. They say, we will not hack him. We will not walk therein. No matter what you tell us. Verse 17, also I set watchmen over you. Pastors, leaders, counselors, I've given them over to you to guide you, to instruct you, to counsel you, to admonish you, to pray for you, to see that you don't fall into wrong places. God said, I set watchmen over you, saying, hearken to the sound of the trumpet. The trumpet is blowing right now. The trumpet is blowing right now. Listening to the sound of the trumpet of the word of God, the bread of life, the only key to life. But they said, we will not hearken. That kind of spirit will not come to you. Yeah. I said, that kind of spirit will not be upon you. Yeah. You know the meaning of what they're saying. They're saying, Jeremiah, whatever grammar you blow, whatever jargon you speak, we will not, as for that man, no going back. As for that woman, no going back. I've made up my mind. I've given my heart to him. I've given my heart to her. No going back. Daddy, there's no amount. No, even if you pray for 7 days on the mountain, and you fast, and you weep, and you cry, for this man, no going back. You will bear the brunt. You will cry. You will weep. And that means you may not even make heaven, because marriage can make or break, it will make you.
Amen.
Give me a louder amen.
Amen.
As for that Absalom, I can't see such Absalom in it. I just look at the rank and file of all the workers and leaders and members of the church. This man is special. I can't find such a man in the church. You can't find a devil in the church. You want a devil, you will get it. You will get it. So don't bother to tell me to go this way because he's so handsome to refuse to reject. He's so pretty to refuse to reject. Not like her in my fellowship. So soft, so sweet, so caring, so loving. In fact, the way she handles me is as if we are married. Solomon has an answer. He said, travel with me to Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 8. He said, better, lady. Don't look at the beginning, the periphery. Better, lady. Young man, better is the end of a thing than what? Than the beginning. Better. Can you remember when you were in primary school, there are some boys and girls that you so much appreciate? Where are they now? I love him. I love him. Where is she now? When you were in secondary school, didn't you have somebody running after you? Somebody you are running after? Maybe you didn't even commit sin, but you just appreciate him. Where is he now? And there are new people and new faces now in the university. And you are still going to meet new faces and new people where you in the workplace. Who knows that which will give you peace? Who knows that which will give you joy? After toiling, after suffering, like the bitter said, during the winter, during the summer, come rain, come sunshine. Now for you to sit down and enjoy life and enjoy the fruit of your labor, then that's why becomes a thorn in your flesh, you have to stay in the place of work till 10 p.m. before coming home to see that they are slept. Then, before she wakes up, you are gone. You better listen to Solomon. He said, better is the end of a thing than the beginning. She may look good, sweet. She may even be a solace. I'm telling you, she may be a solace. I'm not talking about that one that was just mentioned. So don't worry, my dear. But the point I'm making is this. It can be somebody so wonderful in the fellowship, and it may be somebody that will be Satan incarnate tomorrow. And that is the trouble that people fall into, because they allow their eyes to guide them. Solomon said, better is the end of a thing than the beginning thereof. And he said, and the patient in spirit, the one who doesn't want to take all tea very fast and burn our tongue or punt our lips, patient in spirit than the one that is proud in spirit. I pray that the Lord Almighty God will deliver you all in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Basis for dating strategy. Let's go to the beginning of the Bible, Genesis. Basis for dating strategy that works. Genesis chapter 2, we read from verse 18. If you can be very fast, it will help me to read from the screen here. Genesis chapter 2, we read from verse what?
18.
Thank you very much. And the Lord said, it is not good that the man should be alone. I will make him an helpmate for him. Let's take note of the word. The problem many people have is that when they read, they rush. They don't read patiently and slowly to really get the nugget, to really get the insight that God wants to give out of the word. It says, and the Lord God said, it is not good that the man should be alone. Then he said, I will make. Not daddy will make, not mommy will make, not pastor will make, not choir leader will make. There is no matchmaker among men. God is the only qualified personality, qualified matchmaker. I will make him and help meet the one that will pray along with him, the one that will partner him, the one that will fellowship with him, the one that will provide for him, the one that will take care of him, the one that will comfort him, the one that will encourage him, the one that when he sees her, he will be happy and help meet the qualified one, faithful one, submissive one, obedient one, loyal one, the one that is caring, the one that is soft, the one that is obedient, the one that is submissive, and will make and help me, the one that will prepare his table, prepare his, wash his underwears, take care of his clothes, take care of the flock, take care of the children, and help me, comforting help me. Say comforting help me. A louder amen.
Amen.
That's what God's I will. That's the basis. That's the foundation. That is the bedrock of a blissful home. He said, I will. Adam never knew he needed a woman. It never occurred to him. It was God-oriented. It was God's initiation. It came from him. And it is God who instituted it. Because he said, it is not good. He looked at him. If this one should be alone in this big house, this big garden, look at animals, they have partners. The lion has partner. The sheep has partner. The goat has partner. Even the dog, they have partners. Snake have partners. If this man should be alone, do like this once again. Do it very well. And raise it up to him. Praise the Lord. God is too, I don't know the grammar I can use. The adjective. He looked at him that this man will soon become a moron. We should become he will soon become mad. Loneliness is not good. Loneliness is killing. Many people, because of loneliness, they have mental problems. Am I right?
Yes.
God look at him that this man can become mad. It cannot be fellowshipping with animals and they be talking to each other and be fellowship and friendship. It's just this man needs somebody. But now you are running ahead of God. I need somebody. You know I need somebody. I look at this one in the choir that is playing organ, and you don't trick it for me. Go ahead and do it. Go ahead. God said, it is not good for you. After graduation, when you finish your course, it's not good for you to be alone. It will not help you. You are coming out of many people in the college, in the university. Now you are renting a flat, and then from sitting room to the room, from the room to the toilet, from the toilet to the kitchen, and then from the kitchen you come to the sitting room again, you sit down, then television will not be your companion. God said, no, I don't want you to be alone. If I don't read the Bible, it's a problem. If I don't pray, it's a problem. If I don't in the kitchen, it's a problem. God said, I don't want man or woman to be alone. I want to make an help me for him. I know the one that is good for him. I know the one that is appropriate. And he made it happen. Praise the Lord. Let's read further. And out of the ground, the Lord God formed every beast of the field and every fowl of the air and brought them unto Adam to see what he would call them. And whatsoever Adam called every living creature, that was the name thereof. And Adam gave names to all cattle, and to the fowl of the air, and to every beast of the field. But for Adam there was not found an helpmeet for him. Look up here. Adam, perfect, holy. He has the nature of God. Look at all the animals in the world. Adam gave names to all of them. That's great. That's great. The fellowship between him and God was superb. They were friends. They fellowshiped together. They talked together. So, what are you going to call this one? This one is lion. What are you going to call this one? This one is leopard. What are you going to call this one? This one is eagle. What are you going to call this one? This is a fish. Perfect relationship. Holy Ghost filled man. He was spiritually saturated with grace and power of the Holy Spirit. The word of knowledge is there full in him. He knew. See, then and in verse 21, and God and the Lord God caused a deep sleep. Everybody say deep sleep.
Deep sleep.
Louder, please.
Deep sleep.
He caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam. You know, you doctors, you know what you make you do before you cut somebody. I don't know what he used, but he just made him to sleep. The Bible didn't tell us whether he used any substance, and I know he didn't use any substance because he just said, let there be, let there be, and the whole world came into existence. Am I right?
Yes.
He made him to sleep and brought out a bone. I want you to follow me. He brought out a bone. Then he used it, he went to his manufacturing company. He went to the theater and fashioned a woman. Clap for God. Amen. See, these creatures that are looking here, they are bones of some men. But they don't know which of the men. They don't know which of the men. You are a bone belonging to an individual. It will take the spirit that was in Adam for you to identify him. And when he finished the job, he brought her to Adam. Who brought her to Adam?
Yes.
Louder, please.
Yes.
Is it pastor in the church?
No.
The choir master?
No.
The head usher?
No.
Your mom?
No.
Your dad?
No.
God brought her unto him. It originated from him. The idea came from him. He saw the necessity. He worked it out. He completed it and brought her to him. And when she got to him, as usual, he looked at her. He looked up and down. He looked at the anatomy. He examined everything. He said, "This is the bone of my bones." Only one bone, out of many bones. This is the bone of my many bones. And she shall be called, what?
Woman.
It came from Adam. He recognized it with spiritual discernment. Hallelujah.
Amen.
These eyes you have is just to see that you don't fall into the gutter. You can't see afar off. You can't see. We can't see afar off. And when they came together, both of them were naked. And they were not ashamed. They were naked. There was no sampling. Adam wasn't sampling. Even if he wanted to sample, there was only one person around. But let me sample this one. Let me try this one. Try and error. Let me try this one. Maybe this one will work. Not Adam. No sampling. No trial. Herod. No guessing. Maybe it's this, maybe this is not this. Adam never missed it. He knew it by the gift of the Spirit in him. This is the bone of my bones, the flesh of my flesh. And she shall be called woman. Woman, out of man, out of me. Praise the Lord. Which means then, before you can have the mind of God on any subject, you must sleep. Tell your neighbor, sleep.
Sleep.
Close your eyes and sleep. That's the basis. He was fast asleep. He didn't know when it happened. God brought her to him. And in this chapter, I see prayer. I see patience. I see perception. I see positive reaction. He didn't say, I can't take this one. I can't take this one. It's not tall enough. It's not short enough. I want a slimming person. I want somebody that is light in complexion. I want somebody from Anambra State. I want somebody from Oyo State. No, sir. There was a kind of positive reaction and acceptance. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I repeat myself. I see prayer here. I see patience here. He was just patiently waiting for what God will do. He's the one who mooted the idea. The thing came from him, not from me. Patience. And there was perception. He was able to perceive. This is the bone of my bone. And we could see positive reaction and acceptance. And permanent adherence. Permanent adherence. He had an heir with her. She had heir with him. For this purpose, for this reason, shall a man leave his father and mother and be joined and be cleaved with his wife. And they two will become what? One. That's the scripture. And then we see particulars being exchanged. But if there's a particulars, let me see your data page. My name is this, my name is this, I live at this, this is my age, this is from my time. What's the particulars of this car? This is it, the engine number, this is the chassis number, this is it. The engine particulars. How do I know that? The two of them cohabited together, naked, they exposed themselves to each other. Adam was able to know that it's the bone of his bones. When you want to cut somebody and you don't know the details about that person, you don't know how many times she has aborted, you don't know whether she has a womb or not, you don't know whether the man is impotent. We are your parents, we know what is happening. Impotent man wanting to marry, an HIV person wanting to marry. Thank God for Pastor W. Kumoyi that he brought up the idea of going to the hospital to know your genotype. Then we began to discover. This one is having I was in Oyo State. I have somebody that had this problem of HIV and he was able to marry. Another person wanted to marry, but after prayer with her, she became set free. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
To the glory of God. I say, praise the Lord.
Amen.
The point I'm making is this. The person you don't know, whether she's menstruating or she's not menstruating, whether he's impotent or he's not impotent, you want to go along with him, with her. Basis. I remember a woman, a man said, God said I should marry you. Me? Marry me? I have no more. That's my particulars. She opened up. She said, but God said I should marry you. Then he took her to the mother. Tell your mother. Oh, praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord for such a church that we have. I said, praise the Lord.
Amen.
Please tell your mom that I have no one. He told his mom. Mom said, but I still love you. I like you. You know what? They married. And after marriage, each time our Baba is praying, praying for people, always putting her hand in her womb. Always putting her hand in her womb. She has four boys.
Yes.
I'm talking about the person I know very well. Where I came from, the lady very beautiful, but she never menstruated. The young man has run away. The lady abandoned. He's married to another person. But you said it's the will of God. If he had prayed very well, wouldn't God have revealed to him? Answer me.
Yes.
Answer me.
Yes.
The basis. Prayer, patience, perception, positive reaction and acceptance, permanent adherence, particulars being a change, openness and honesty, telling of the past life you have lived. Romans 8:14. For as many as are led by the Spirit of the Lord, they are the sons of God. That's the basis. In John chapter 9, verse 31, for we know that God heareth not sinners, but if anyone be a worshipper of God, him God heareth. That's the basis. You want God to tell you of tomorrow, and you are not born again, and you are not a Christian, how will the Spirit of God lead you? As many as are led of the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. I remember the case of Saul. In his good old days, Pastor Saul, King Saul, he drove out all witches and wizards from the land. Then he went out of the way of righteousness because of envy and jealousy. He wanted to kill David for no just cause. And the demons came upon his life. Then he called upon God. God never answered him by dream, by Urim, or by Thummim. Then he said, seek for me a woman that has familiar spirit. But can you remember your old days? How you drove them out of the city? There was one in Endor. She couldn't live around because you drove them away in those days. Don't worry, seek for me. When you no longer hear the voice of God, then you go to a prophet somewhere. Is Dorcas the will of God for me? Is Deborah the right person to marry? Then the prophet will look up and look down. Is she short? Yes, yes. It studies you, the way you are reacting. Not too short. Yes, you are right. Not too short. Because the God of heaven is no longer answering. You have gone out of the way. All those who have gone out of the way will come back.
Amen.
Give me another amen.
Amen.
So what are we talking about? The basis. There was a kind of fellowship, relationship between God and Adam. And for that reason, God made him to know the woman to marry. So it is possible to be led of God's Spirit on any subject. But there must be consistent father-son relationship. I am the good shepherd, and I know my sheep, and I'm known of mine. John 10:14. My sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. John 10:27. To be led of God demands that you get rid of God's skin, stubborn spirit. You should not be rigid and stubborn like a goat. Be sheepish in nature, teachable in nature, easily controlled and directed. Put away the idol of beauty, ungodly motive, family and educational attainment, choice of tribe and nationality. Remember, Paul said, Lord, what would thou have me to do? That is how to know the will of God. What would thou have me to do? Which direction do you want me to go? Who is he? Where is he? How can I get him? Of what village, of what town, of what city is he? Why should we do that? Proverbs 14:12. Open that, let's read. Proverbs 14:12. There is a way which seemeth right unto a man, but the end thereof are the ways of what? Death. This is the reason why We must make sure we have fellowship with God. We are born again. We have the Spirit of God to guide us, to direct us. I wonder why somebody from the village will be looking for a German to marry. Is he from Germany? Is he from America? What is Germany? What is America? We are talking about rest. We are talking about peace. We are talking about longevity. We are talking about enjoyment in the family, fulfilling the purpose of family on earth. We are talking about an American. One man many years ago came to Nigeria and wanted to marry. He had married over there. He had certificates in his bag. But God arrested him, caught him. He brought the certificate in the bag and brought it to Nigeria. He has seen a lady yonder in our place. The lady has accepted, and America has come. Then the man he was staying with, when the man was not around, the guest was not around, the host, the Holy Ghost said, open his bag. Open his bag. Open his bag. But the owner of the bag is, open his bag. He obeyed. The host opened the bag. He saw a certificate of marriage. He had broken the marriage in America. He wanted to enslave another woman. Those of you that are looking for a German, an American, if God had not intervened, what would have happened? Answer me. They have presented a couple of stories how they were led. This, the woman was ready to marry. Until the certificate of marriage was found. But because he had a problem, you see, when you go to America, you go to Germany, you go to any of these countries and you marry the nationals there, those nationals don't want to come where there is no light consistently. They don't want to come where there is no air conditioner. And you are just starting life. You want to bring them there and that. So your country is full of darkness like this. The roads are so bad like this. And things are not good as it's supposed to be. And eventually, before you know it, she runs away. Then it becomes a problem to you. I know somebody like that. I've never met him myself, but related to my wife. Married to an American. And the man went to work. By the time she planned and took visa and took everything for him and for her and the children, the whole woman didn't know anything in the house. And the children were saying, Mama, we are traveling today. Shut your mouth, where are you traveling to? The children were saying, Mama, we are traveling today. Mommy is taking us away today. Mommy didn't, the whole woman didn't know anything. The husband has traveled, has gone to work. Before he came back, the woman, the children, up to today, is married to another person. Marriage. It is the work of God only. Can I hear amen?
Amen.
There is a way that looks good at the beginning, but the end thereof are the ways of death. Biblical dating strategy that works. Jeremiah 33:3. Call unto me, and I will answer thee. Which means prayer. Everybody say prayer.
Prayer.
Speak louder.
Prayer.
Speak louder.
Prayer.
Have you prayed before and God answered you? If you have prayed before and God answered, raise up your hand. Clap for Jesus Christ. Unto me, and I will answer thee and show thee. It's very clear. And show thee. I will open your eyes to see. I will open your ears to hear. I will make you to have the feeling of it inside you. I will show you great and mighty things which thou knowest not about him. The secret of the man I will show you. The secret of the woman I will show you. That man is occultic. That man is deceiving you. It's God that can tell you that. It is God that can tell you that by his spirit. Ask and shall be given unto you. Jesus also said, seek and ye shall find. Knock and it shall be opened unto you. Which means then, if we pray persistently, if we pray fervently, God will reveal the man. He will reveal the woman. He will reveal the place of work to us. He will reveal the place to build, to buy a landed property. You know, people buy landed property, they cannot stay there because of the menace of armed robbers. Because of the wicked people around that are diabolical. People build houses, they cannot live there. It's not every place of what you can walk. It's not every hospital you can walk. It is the place where God says go. The salary may not be as fat as one, the other one. But God knows that it is there you will have peace. It is there you will have joy. He knows the end from the beginning. He knows the beginning from the end. He knows everything about us. Come unto me, and I will answer thee, and show thee great and mighty things which thou knowest not. Look at 1 Kings chapter 14. Let's read that story. 1 Kings chapter 14. Reading from verse 1. At that time, Abijah, the son of Jeroboam, fell sick. And Jeroboam said to his wife, arise, I pray thee, and disguise thyself. Think about that. Disguise thyself, that thou be known, that thou be not known to be the wife of Jeroboam, and get thee to Shiloh. Behold, there is Ahijah the prophet, which told me that I should be king over these people. And take with thee 10 loaves and crackers and a goose of honey, and go to him, and shall tell thee what shall become of the child. And Jeroboam's wife did so, and arose, and went to Shiloh, and came to the house of Ahijah. But Ahijah could not see, for his eyes were set by reason of his age. Look up here. A demonized woman may pretend. Disguise. You may be a star in the kingdom of Christ to demolish the kingdom of darkness. And the devil has tried you many, many times. They couldn't get you. What are you going to do to this man? If we allow him to continue the way he's going, he's going to devastate our kingdom. All right, let's set up some women to go and try him, make him to fall into adultery. You must have been watching some Nigerian films. Go and set him up. Let him commit fornication with you. Oh, pretend to love. Go and join yourself to the fellowship. The devil. Devil bastard. Stand to go and be a member of the church. And they will come. They will dress like you. Before you know it, they become members of the choir. Before you know it, they become workers in the church. Before you know it, they are doing everything. They are very close to the pastor. Before you know it, the pastor is already having feelings towards her. It's like the Lord is leading me to this, wanting me to be an in-law to the devil. It's like the devil wants, it's like this lady is the will of God for my life. You want to be an in-law to the devil. If the devil is your father-in-law, you are in trouble. You are in trouble. And before you, for the purpose of your future, to destroy your ministry, to destroy something. Delilah came up to destroy something. Please entice him. Let us know where his power lies. Satan, subtle, more than all the beasts of the earth. That's what the Bible calls him. See how he started with that woman. Did God say, thou shalt not eat any fruit at all? Look at that kind of equation. Painting God to be evil, painting God to be wicked, presenting himself to be nice, to Eve. Eve didn't know. She did not know that she was here for trouble. In an attempt to defend God, she began to explain, no, our God is great. He's a gracious God. He didn't say, he only said we should not eat. Why did he say, if he loves you, why did he say you should not take that one? Because he said if we eat with that, you know it's a lie. God does not want you to be like him. That is what put the whole world into trouble. If we go that way that you are thinking and proposing in your heart, and you know quite well it's not the will of God, you will come and tell me the side of the story. If we meet again, the Lord will give you grace to reject it.
Amen.
Give me another amen.
Amen.
And she comes in, and eventually the knot is tied. And she began to torment you, harass your life. And it's not allowing you to fulfill your ministry. And you are weeping and you are crying. Like Samson. Samson couldn't live long. He died young. He never even got children. He never finished. He died prematurely. Who wants to die prematurely here? Raise up your hand. You want to be fulfilled in life? Raise up your hand. We shall all be fulfilled in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
What are we talking about? See, disguise yourself to be the wife, not to be the wife of Jeroboam. And she came. Look at what happened in the next verse. And the Lord said unto Ahijah, behold, the wife of Jeroboam cometh to ask a thing of thee for her son, for he is sick. Thus and thus shalt thou say unto her, for it shall be, when she cometh him, that she shall feign herself to be another what?
Woman.
Another what?
Woman.
She will feign herself to be a righteous woman, loving woman, wonderful man, caring man, loving man, obedient man. How can you know this with your, these two eyes, small ones? Except God opens our eyes to see. And God told him everything before our arrival. Let's see the next verse. Thus and thus shall thou say unto her, for it shall be, when she cometh in, that she shall paint herself to be another woman. And it was so, when Ahijah had the sound of her feet, though he could not see physically, but she could see spiritually, and she came in at the door, that he said, come in, thou wife of who? Jeroboam, why feigning thyself? Why disguising yourself to be the wife of another woman? Why are you pretending to be a wonderful sister? You want me to fall? Come on, get out of my sight. Why are you pretending to be a wonderful brother? And you are, see, we have just had a message now. After service, you are touching the delicate part of my body. Come on, get close, get out of my sight. Say it, let me hear you.
Get out of my sight.
Speak it loud. That grace will come upon your life.
Amen.
A lot of amen.
Amen.
What are we talking about? We are talking about the importance of prayer. Then we can be led by the word of God. That word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Sons of Solomon's 8:7. By strong, holy, agape, and uninfluenced, undiluted love. You are trying to shake it out of you, it's still there. Many waters cannot quench it. Many flood cannot, much flood cannot quench it. Flood of doubt, flood of criticisms, flood of anger from the parents, flood of rejection cannot quench the agape, undiluted, not self-motivated love. It's there, glued to your heart, not lost. By dream and vision of the night, Job 33:14-17, God makes us to have, if I've ever dreamed before, if I've ever dreamt before, raise up your hand. You have dreamt before. Okay, let me ask you this question. If you have dreamt before and it came to pass, raise up your hand. Raise it up very well, let me see. That is it. God leads. Even he leads up believers. Pharaoh, he led him. Nebuchadnezzar, he led him in his love to fulfill his will in their generation. He gave dreams to them and brought his own children to come and interpret for them so that he could establish his will in their own time. How much more when you are a child of God, as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. You see that in Job 33, verses 14-17. by intuition through the Holy Spirit. Acts 8:23, it says, "For I perceive that thou art in a god of bitterness and the bond of iniquity." I perceive. He was able to perceive that that man was not converted. That man was demonic. That man was having witchcraft. That man is diabolical. He was able to perceive by the Holy Spirit within him. Then by audible voice. Acts 10:19-21. Peter had a revelation when he was hungry. And he saw heaven open and a sheet come down filled with different kinds of meats. And God told him, the Spirit told him, he said, "No, I can't eat, it's unclean." It didn't happen first time, second time, the third time. Then while he was meditating, and maybe he sat down like this, what kind of revelation is this? I am a child of God, holy, sanctified, filled with the Spirit of God. Why should God be telling me to take something that is not clean? It is forbidden. It's written in the book of the law that we should not take this kind of beast, we should not take that other kind of beast, we should not take that other kind. As was, maybe he did like this, meditating, and what kind of vision is this? What kind of trance is this? Then the Holy Ghost spoke unto him, "Three men are seeking for you. Arise and go with them, doubting nothing, for I have what? Sent them." Audible voice. Let's read the one that is very interesting. All of them are interesting, but this one, by dramatic and supernatural events. 1 Samuel 9:14-20. 1 Samuel 19. Chapter 9. We are going to read from verse 14. "And they went up into the city. And when they were coming to the city, behold, Samuel came out against them for to go up to the high place." Let me tell you the background story. Kish lost some asses. And he told Saul, his son, to go and look for those asses. And Saul took one of his servants along. And they went everywhere, combed everywhere. They could not find it. And then they were tired of going up and down. Then they decided to go back home so that it should not be a problem to the parents. Then the servant said, "But there is a seer around, a prophet around. Let us go and inquire from him." Saul said, "But we don't have anything in our hand." The man said, "No, the servant." Servant said, "I have some things in my pocket that we can give to the seer, to the prophet." And so they went, verse 14. "And they went up into the city, and when they were coming to the city, behold, Samuel came out against them for to go up to the high place. Now the Lord had told Samuel, 'He is here.' A day before Saul came, saying, 'Tomorrow, about this time, I will send thee a man out of the land of Benjamin, and thou shalt anoint him to be king over my people Israel, that he may save my people out of the hand of the Philistines, for I have looked upon my people because their cry is come unto me.' And when Samuel saw Saul, the Lord said unto him, 'Behold, the man whom I spoke to thee, of the same shall reign over my people.' Then Saul drew near to Samuel in the gate and said, 'Tell me, I pray thee.' He did not even know him to be Samuel. 'Where is the seer's house?' And Samuel answered Saul and said, 'I am the seer. Go up before me unto the high place, for ye shall eat with me today, and tomorrow I will let thee go, and will tell thee all that is in thy heart. As for thy houses that were lost 3 days ago, set not thy mind on them, for they are found already.'" Look up here. He had audible voice. It was arranged by God. God didn't tell me, but I guess that God made those asses to get lost. and pushed and influenced the brother to send Saul to go and look for them. And they could not find it. And then he influenced the servant also to say, let us go to the seer. But we have nothing in our pocket. The servant still said, we have something to give. That's God at work. Clap for him. If you clap for me like that, I'll not take it. Amen. That is how he was able to anoint him the king over his people. Let me read this to you. Marriage is a lifetime contract between husband and wife. It is binding on both of them until death do them part. No man, no court, no parents, or any unpleasant circumstances like lack of money, impotency, such as poverty, barrenness, insanity. But he's mad. How can I continue to live with him? But she's mad. None of you will be mad.
Yeah.
Give me another amen.
Yeah.
How can I continue with such a situation? I'm tired. See, we have not got any child. I have to have children. I have to do this. And there's prayer here, parents are pressurizing. Can't you do something? Can't you do something? But we cannot do that. But I'm the child of God. God will forgive you. When David did it, God forgave him. It did not happen to any of us. Not even demon possession or promiscuous life of either of the couple. Mutilation of the body by accident. God is involved in ghastly accident and he cannot walk. We cannot even relate again because of the situation. How can I remain like this? I'm just 35. I'm just 39. I'm getting to 40 now. It is in the world that we have that excuse. It's not excusable before God. Not accident so long as she is still breathing. As long as he is still alive, no case can untie the wedlock that is scripturally tied and glued together. You cannot even say, oh God, let him die. God will not even hear. It is that time he will be stronger. Let her die. Oh God, let her die. Die? God will not even hear that kind of prayer. Because you have entered into it, you have entered, you cannot come out. The Bible calls we say wedlock. Everybody say wedlock. Let's separate them into wed and lock. Look, as from the welder. When they want to weld something together, they will really weld it together. And then ask if you want to lock something together that it will be separate, we lock it together. Then wed and lock. How do we break it? That's what the Bible calls cleave. Leave and do what? And cleave. To be glued together. To make it inseparable. Fasten together. Therefore, there's need for caution. Don't pick by sight. It will sell you to the unknown Delilah or Absalom. Walking by sight will bring mystical and diabolical Jezebel, Athaliah the murderer, or into your life to ruin you. From time immemorial, God has been faithfully and lovingly leading his own people. He led Abraham. He led Eliezer. He led Israel. Lastly, what is the blueprint for actualization? What is the blueprint? Let's begin with Proverbs 11:14. Proverbs 11:14. Proverbs 11:14. Where no counsel is, the people fall. Everybody read it with me.
Where no counsel is, the people fall.
That is why those pastors are there. Where no counsel is, the people fall. But in the multitude of counselors, there's what?
Safety.
There's safety. After knowing the will of God, you go to your pastor. Don't go to him. Don't go to her. Don't do like Sabakas, the dogs on the street. Don't turn the church into nightclubs. Paul Apostle said, let all things be done decently and in order. Church is different from the world. They don't take permission in the world. Dogs don't take permission from themselves. Oh yeah, they continue. But in the church, we don't do that. You go to the pastor first because he knows everybody. Where I came from, my interpreter, married with children, one of the sisters came and said, Pastor, I've been led by the Lord. And who is that person? My interpreter. I said, okay, go and pray again. I didn't say no, I didn't say yes, go and pray. She went, she came back. She went and came back. They thought when I saw that she was coming to be positive, I said, sister, he's married with children. If she has gone to him, what shame, what ridicule. Bro, I've been willing to see you, and I want to tell you something that God is, do you get me a good job? No, not job. What are you talking about? Marriage? She'll be put to shame, am I right? Yes. But I'm married. You want my wife to die? She will hate herself. Am I right? Yes. But that ended between me and her. The man never knew till tomorrow. It ended between the two of us. It has happened many years, more than 16 years ago. But we have to give it as an example so that we can be careful and do things decently and in order in the church. Then there's what we're talking about now is pastoral counsel and approval. The pastor will say, yes, okay, let me inquire, I will call you back. Then you will call her, ask questions from her. How old are you? What course are you now? I'm in Papa. Oh, you have just come. And how old are you? I'm going to 19. Bro, you have to be patient. You don't even talk to her about it. You don't pollute her mind with it. You don't disturb her, you don't distract her attention with it. That lady is too young now, you cannot even think about marriage. What about if he has gone to him, persuade her, and cajole and deceive her, and then begin to mess up, and she becomes pregnant when she has not even finished backpack? Then you put the mother into trouble, you put the father into trouble, and they weeping, my daughter. Let's have mercy upon these parents. Let's show mercy to them. They love us so much. They are caring for us. They are praying for us. They are weeping because of us. Let us show mercy to our parents. I say, let us show mercy to our parents. Can I hear amen from you?
Amen.
Pastoral counsel and approval. And when everything is okay, the pastor can say, go ahead. Don't meet her at the metro stop. You talk to her after service. Sister, please, I want to see. Oh, I'm in a hurry. Please. Is it fine? Wait now. Be patient with me now. Something very important. What is it? I want to go. And that is the bread and tea she will eat. Praise the Lord. Then after that, parental consent. Don't steal another person's daughter away from them. Don't break their hearts. Don't deceive her and run away to Germany. How dare you go into marriage without blessing from the parents, from your dad and your mom, to pray for you? Parental consent. You will see that in Genesis 24. Let's go there. Genesis 24. If you can put it on for me, I will appreciate it so much. From 49. Genesis 24. From 49. And now, if you will deal kindly and truly with my master Abraham, tell me, if not, tell me that I may turn to the right hand or to the left, that is the servant of Abraham. After he had prayed, O God, as I come to this place now by this well, let any woman that I say give me water to drink, and without asking her to give to my animals, let her be the wife of Isaac, Eliezer of Damascus. Immediately she finished praying, God moved Rebecca. Go and fetch water. Go and fetch water. Go and fetch water. God will move you to go and fetch water. And when he moves you to fetch water, you get him. Can I hear amen?
Amen.
As she was coming like this, he said, please, can you give me water to drink? Oh, I will give you water to drink. Not only you, even to your animals. Everything work out perfectly. God answers prayer. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Then when he got to the house, now he now began to tell them, let's read 49 again. Let's read 49 again. 49. And now if you will dig kindly, he was now talking to the people. The parents of Rebecca, I'm truly with my master. Tell me, and if not, tell me that I may turn to the right hand or to the left. The next verse, 50. Then Laban and Bethuel answered and said, the thing proceeded from the Lord, we cannot speak unto thee bad or good. 51. Behold, Rebecca is here before you. Take her and go, and let her be thy master's son's wife, as the Lord has spoken. That is parental what? Please, louder.
Consent.
Immediately they gave their consent. He gave gold. They feasted. They had. They drank. They rejoiced. And when he said, oh, let me now go, they said, so quick. Let us stay with us 10 days. Daughter, that is why you see them weeping when you are going. They don't want you to go, but you just must go. The love of parents. You see daddy weeping. You see mommy weeping. They don't want their daughter to go. And then you want to go without them praying for you because of one man in America. Which man? Which America? You will suffer. I pray that will not be your portion.
Amen.
Give me another amen.
Amen.
After reluctant consent, we have profitable and God-honoring conscience. You still come back to give the feedback to the pastor. We went, it was wonderful. They accepted us. In fact, they killed a cow because of us. And they come and see jubilation, come and see this and that. And by the time you are going there, one man will follow the man, one woman will follow the woman, so that you don't die on the way spiritually. We have seen many cases of people who fail during courtship. As if they don't believe that Jesus will soon come. Profitable and God-honoring courtship. Then while you are doing that, then you will have praying, or you pray for successful courtship and marriage. You'll be praying so that attack will not come. People, they just enjoy themselves. They go to for picnic. They go for that. They go to the shopping mall. They go to one place there. They want to sit down. And where they are sitting down to eat McDonald's and whatever they are eating there. Not McDonald's. What do they eat there? Huh? Donut and tea and chai and so on. And they are seeing people that are behaving like dogs there. And they are moved themselves, and they are tempted themselves, and they fall themselves. Who will repent? Who will repent? Who will repent? How many people went into it? They couldn't make repentance, and the devil kept on tormenting them, tormenting them, tormenting them, because they could not, they were not bold enough to make restitution. Then planning on financial implication of that marriage. accommodation, children, dependents. How many children are we going to have? Four, two boys, two girls, if God allows, or only two, only four, only six. They agree. Do we allow our mother-in-law to come? They agree. It is that time they plan on how to set up their family. Provision for the marriage program and other means. Then there'll be public declaration. Public declaration. Both in the court and the church. Brother and so, the usher, this, has seen the will of God to so and person, this. If you have anything to say before actualization, please come and tell us. Otherwise, you keep your mouth shut forever and ever. Public declaration. Then the wedding. And the wedding should not be done in a way that you incur debts. You begin your family with debts. You borrow money to buy a car. You borrow money to buy a chair. You borrow money to buy spoons. You borrow money to buy a gown. You borrow money to do this and do that. No. Live within your means. Buy the white gown that is not exposed. White gown that is not what? Exposed. How can somebody be saying you are my wife and you are selling your body to all the onlookers? Thing that is for me alone. You now make it public. Shame. Something that is just for your man. You want other people to see it. Shame. Everybody say shame.
Shame.
Everybody say shame.
Shame.
Something that is meant for your man, your sweetheart. You now advertise. Everybody is now looking at that place. And then you make it to begin to fall and come and mess up with themselves in the church. Then you go home with a curse instead of with a blessing. That will not be your portion.
Amen.
You know, somebody can come to the church and go home with a curse because people are falling down and falling to sin, and maybe she's just a pretty woman like that, and they expose the balls, the underwear, everything is armpit, everything is outside, and people are not looking even at the man, it's the woman they are looking at. When they are doing the man, instead of shaking the man, they are shaking the woman. Hand of this one now, they are rejoicing with your wife and they are kissing your wife in your presence. Shame. Shame. Shame on those women that expose their body to the people of the world to see their nakedness. If we go to Exodus 26, God said, as you are climbing up, choir members, don't allow them to see your underwear. It's in Exodus chapter 26. Don't allow them to see it. Now your thing is here. You want to sit and do like this. Let's call a spade a spade. Let's hit the nail on the head. You don't dress in a way to kill people in the church. Even the drama we are looking at, you don't do things that will make people to be lost in their hearts. Not everybody is the same. Not everybody is strong in the same way. You cannot be watching those things. If you're not careful, you become a sinner. A sinner, you become a sinner. Am I right?
Yes.
And they are correcting themselves, and they are touching themselves, and they are touching sensitive places of their bodies. If it causes problem, be careful, beware. Holiness, we are preaching here. Holiness. See how that man, with all his strength, with all his power, he laid down, made us to know the necessity of holiness. Without which no man, no me, not you or myself, we will not see God. We must be holy. And if you want us to be holy, see that in the congregation, don't come and sing here. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So if I don't tell you, who will tell you? Who will tell you? Who will tell you? This is what God has for you concerning dating strategies. That song you sang, I told the camp commandant that, or the moderator that, we want that song again. Maybe after questions. That song is wonderful. We will sing it together. Can I hear amen? Let's rise up to pray. Rise up to pray. Rise up to pray. Let's talk to the Lord in prayer. Promise him you are going to be obedient. If you know you want to be a happy woman in life, a happy man in life, this is the time to really consecrate yourself and make up your mind. This is the time to make up your mind. This is the time to make up your mind. This is the time to make up your mind. This is the time to make up your mind. Look away from her beauty or his handsomeness. Reject it, refuse it. You are still a teenage girl, a teenage boy. Face your studies. Pray that the Lord will help you to be obedient to the will of God. Plead with God for grace. Ask for grace. Ask for mercy and pardon. If you have entered into an equal yoke, tell God to have mercy upon you. Make up your mind that immediately you leave this place, you will tell him bye-bye. You will tell her bye-bye. Promise God that that's what you are going to do. That we say bye-bye to him, bye-bye to her. Make up your mind. Talk to the Lord about it. Tell God to forgive of all the immoralities you have committed with him or with her. In the name of marriage. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Elada, amen.
Amen.
Our Father, we are very grateful unto you for what you have shared with us. We have seen that you love us. You don't want us to be sorrowful in life. You don't want us to regret in life. That is why you have upholded all this unto us. We pray you give us the grace.
Amen.
To be obedient.
Amen.
The grace to do your will.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And when it is time for them to know your mind, your will, on any subject, I pray you will remember your promise that you said we should call upon you and that you will answer.
Amen.
Answer them, O Lord.
Amen.
Let your name be glorified.
Amen.
We pray that you answer their questions.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
A loud amen.
Amen.
I believe you were blessed by that ministration. If you reside in Kharkov, Ukraine, please join us for service on Sundays by 9:45 a.m. and on Wednesdays by 6 p.m. And if you reside outside Ukraine, please follow our YouTube channel and add us as friends on Facebook for more videos and updates. God bless you.